So jewelry is like art, right? Like it can be perceived as art. Like, mm-hmm. So the thing about jewelry, I worked at Rockefeller, you know what I mean, in the heyday. So like, I learned about watches from being around Jay-Z. Yeah. You know what I mean? When he said, this Audemars, this is a 101, like I seen it with my own eyes. So it's like.
That's some legendary shit, I didn't know that.
For real, so it's like, so when people were talking about all this watch stuff, and he used to tell us, like, he used to always tell us, like, yo, buy more watches than chains, because people with chains and the watches is always late, right? And what I started to learn about watches was, like, the first Rolex I bought was a presidential Day-Date. A gold one, and the guy that I bought it from, the jeweler, he was recommended from like a person I'm close to. Mm-hmm. So he was like, yo, I want you to buy something that's gonna attain value in some years. So it was like, you know, I bought it, and when I bought it, I think I spent like $15,000 on it. I think now it's worth like $20,000.
Yeah.
So it's like, the thing about jewelry is like, any and everything, there's cars that you can buy that don't depreciate in value. I'm just finding this out about G-Wagons. Like, G-Wagons don't depreciate in value. Yeah. Like, it's a fly car, but people don't understand that, like, you know, you purchase it and it's like
it maintains its value.
It maintains its value. Yeah. Same as art. I think it's all, but art is all about perception. Now, I'm not with you spending, I get why you want to spend 50 bands on a chain. You know what I mean? Like, it looks pretty, it shines. Yep. You know, the
girls like it.
Oh, the girls like it. But, and this is just me, sometimes I use my faith in like life. It says that like wearing chains is like a wearing a ring of fire around your neck, like because moths attract the what? Fire. Yeah. So it's like, when you wear a chain, it's like a moth to a flame, you know? So there's a metaphor in that.
Yeah.
Do you want that type of attention?
Yeah.
Now, I'm all down for, you know, educating young brothers and sisters about buying the right type of jewelry. Yeah. But at the same time, like, jewelry's an easy thing to learn. Yeah. I want to learn more about the things that you're doing. Yeah. You know, Weezy told me about.
But it's all the same.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, once you know one thing, you know another.
Mm-hmm.
So it's no surprised that Jay was able to transition what he did with Tidal into Square, and
right.
Eventually may make a move into fintech.
Right.
Like, once you know how to buy one thing and know what the value is, like, Rolex is a good investment. I just didn't think you should have got it at the time.
Yeah.
I think you should have got like some.
I bought an ignorant. I bought an ignorant Rolex too.
But
the Rolex, the one I had on yesterday. That watch is ignorant. It has no value, but I bought it because I was bored. Mm. I really bought it because I was bored.
Were you bored or you wanted?
I wanted one.
Yeah.
So I back at Rockefeller, I used to be in. I used to stay a lot of. I spent a lot of time at Beanie Siegel's house.
What year were you there? '03, '04, '05.
I got out the mailroom in like 01.
Oh, you was there doing that.
Yeah. So I was.
Man.
When Beans was on house arrest in like 04, I was living with him. So he had, remember the Jacobs?
Yeah.
He had this Jacob, right, and his yellow and white.
Making a killing.
Oh, he was, it was disgusting. So it was like yellow and white. I think it was like $90,000 for his watch, right? And I used to like, I'm in a house with the watch all the time. I'm like, I would really like to have one of these one day. Like, I would, like, not that, but just a watch with all diamonds. And then like, one day I had nothing to do and I was just like, you know what? I feel like buying that watch.
Yeah.
And I just went and bought it.
Was it like a symbol of validation?
I don't know, because you know what it is? I don't, probably validation within myself.
Yeah.
Because like, I don't really feel like, I don't really like seek validation from other people. I kind of got over that, like making mistakes as a young man. But I felt accomplished. I like accomplishments. Like, I like to make a long drive.
Got you.
Because it makes me feel good when I get there. So it's like, for real, though, seriously. So like, when I got the watch, it was like, it was a good feeling like that week, and then the next week I didn't care.
Yeah.
It did look good though.
It looks good. I love it.
Yeah.
I love my watch, but it's like,
but it's always that letdown. It's no different than like if you got a girl and you cheat, and I'm like, yo, you know, black men don't cheat, but.
Right.
Yeah.
What are you talking about?
But, you know, like, we'll have a high for a moment, and then all of a sudden, it's like same thing with cars. Like,
yeah.
You'll get it, you'll love it for 2 or 3 weeks or 3 months, and then like, why the fuck did I even get this?